Question number 23, we are told four posts A, B, C and D stand on a level horizontal ground. Post B is 240 meters on a bearing of 060 degrees from A. C is 210 meters to the south of B and D is 150 on a bearing of 140 from A. Using a scale of 1 centimeter to represent 30 meters, show the relative positions of the post that you get 4 marks. Okay, the rest of the question, use the scale drawing to find the info. So for you to be able to answer this question, you need to make a sketch, then you will make the real drawing so that you understand how your diagram will look right. So we start from A, we make a compass there, A, and we are told B is 240 meters on a bearing of 60. So it means here we have angle 60, that is angle 60. This is, since it is 240, you divide by 30, there you make 8 centimeter, and this is where we have our point B. Then we are told that C is 210 south of B, so you extend this line, and you, since it is 210, you measure 7 centimeter. 210 divided by 30 is 7. Then D is 150, so you divide by 30, those are 5. 140, since the whole of this angle up to there is 90, you add another angle of 50, so that you get a total of, so this angle is 50, this is 30, so that add up to 140, and this is where you find your D. So from there, now you use the geometrical instruments to draw this figure, and then go ahead and answer the other question. So let's do that. So the first thing you do is to get a compass to represent A, and then you are going to measure an angle of 60 here so that we get B, and we measure 8 centimeter. So let's do that. So this is the angle of 60, and I've measured 8 centimeter up to where we have the green mark. So I'm going to draw a compass there of point B so that we identify point C. So that is the compass of at B, and then we are told that C, this is where we have our C, is 210 kilometers south of south of B. So we need to extend this line here, so that, and then we measure 7 centimeter to represent 210. Kilometer. So let's do that. So this is where I have located my C. I have adjusted my diagram because of space. So finally, so this is 7 from B downwards southwards, 7 centimeter to represent 240 meters. So finally we have D, which is 140 degrees from A, so we get that bearing. This is my final diagram where I have located D here. It is a 5 centimeter representing 150. So what I have done is that since this angle here is 30, those two add up to 90, then I have added an angle of 50, so that the total of this angle is 140, which is a bearing of D from A. So with that, we can go ahead and answer the other questions. So use your to find the distance and the bearing of C from D. So what you do is to draw a line that is, find the bearing of C from D, join D and C, and measure the angle at D to get the bearing of C from D. So when I join D and C, I find that the bearing of C that is B, B Roman number 1, my diagram is giving me 83 degrees, and the distance I'm getting 2.9. So it means 2.9 you multiply by 30, 2.9 you multiply by 30, and you get that is equals to 87 meters. So that is part B of the question. We go to C. Before we go to C, we look at Roman number 2 of B. Determine how far A is to the west. So I've drawn a line here, which I found it is 6 centimeter. So it means it is 6 multiplied by 30, and that is giving me 180 meters. So A, we say A to the west of B. Then finally C, that the height of the post D is 18. Calculate correct to two decimal places the angle of elevation of the top of post D from the foot of A. So we can use this triangle. You can say this is how it looks like. So this is post D, which is 18 meters, and from here it is we are told that so this distance is 150. So we want to get that angle of elevation theta. So we can say tan theta is equals to 18 divided by 150, which is giving us 0.12, implying that the tan inverse theta is equals to, we are getting 6.84 degrees. So that's how you work out that question, and you earn yourself 10 marks.